Funk or die.
Cut it up, son. It's filthy, nigga. Lash, rest in peace, AL, cookie up next. Lil Yeah representing for the whole Jets. He think he a hot boy, I make a cold mess. 7'6" and let that boy solar rest. I was really in the kitchen making soda stretch. Now I'm passing down the torch to the niggas next.
Oh yeah, y'all know what's up, man. Shit, we ain't doing that now. You're fucking around in the hood, man. Getting this shit in. You know, I've been fucking with Filthy, man, since he was a jit. Young nigga been loving him, you know what I mean? Before all this whole other shit, man, we been getting it in. Real good nigga. If any nigga wanna know some genuine shit, y'all know. You feel what I'm saying? But that's my guy, man. You know what I mean? We been holding it down, putting it in, man. You know what I mean? And getting it in. Like a motherfucker. Other than that shit, it been all good, man. You feel me? I ain't shit, man. The truth in the pudding, I ain't got too much to say. They already know what the fuck going on, shit, man. It's self-explanatory, man. You feel what I'm saying? It ain't undercover. It's in y'all face. You feel me? Everybody getting to it. We represent the label. You feel me? And we pushing on that shit, period. Outside. You feel me? And they be saying, man, woo, woo, this, that, and all. You niggas, man, we out here, man. You feel me? Period. Y'all know what's up, man. F-O-D-E-N-T.
On forms of millions on my neck. Bitch, I ran through them M's and had some millions left. A couple niggas stay solid, couple niggas left. We resort to violence when it comes to F. Been putting on for the East since I came in it. Really fucked up the game and then I came in it. Bitch, I seen the paperwork, it got your name in it. So I don't understand why you keep explaining it. MVP on my jersey, I'm just hanging it. Gonna retire with the W, ain't no changing it. Still got the rollie on me, ain't no playing in it. Yeah, you was fucking with them suckers, you was ganging it. Too many politics, I'm rearranging it. A lot of niggas sell their soul for this famous shit. 11 years old, I jumped off the porch. Couldn't imagine one day I'd be jumping out of force. Heat the Pyrex and scrape it with a fork. Y'all can have this rap shit, I'm passing down the torch. 11 years old, I jumped off the porch. Couldn't imagine one day I'd be jumping out of force. Heat the Pyrex and scrape it with a fork. Y'all can have this rap shit, I'm passing down the torch. Live. Shout out to All Black, was rocking All Black.
We just want everybody's attention real fast, just real fast. We here. Everybody got their glass?
Yeah, I drank. Oh, yeah.
Listen, today not only marks 10 years in the game, but a grinding of somebody that really started at the bottom, man, to be able to say, I really climbed my way up to the top. I really worked to get to the spot and the position that I'm in. For anybody that's been here since the beginning, you know how far the journey has gone, how long it's taken, feeling myself. Went to high school together, so if anyone would know, I understand the journey for so long of us just going after it, trying to get it, trying to chase it, trying to make it, getting to the top, the competition of brothers, the rivalry of those of trying to be in there, of everything that we've done for one person being in a position to be happy for them, from all of the transitions of countless mixtapes, countless nights, working, trying to balance, and off the music, a lot of people don't know, Phil and I's relationship, those 3 a.m. calls, 4 a.m. calls of just, but what you doing? I gotta holler at you. I need somebody to talk to, man. Somebody I know that's been through it. All of these sessions, man, that becomes way more realer than just music and way more realer than just the glare and the flare that a lot of people see. Some of the things that goes unaccounted for, man, from being a father, trying to balance that, to being a music man, to being an entrepreneur, to being somebody that's trying to continue to just grow and elevate. Why others don't want to see that success. I told them that at times we become a whale in a pond. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, when we're in these ponds, all eyes are on us. Mm-hmm. And having that is a lot to deal with. It's very difficult at times mentally, spiritually, and it's physically draining. And it's a lot of the times where people say, man, I want to give this up. I want to leave. I want to be done with it. But our passions always bring us back. So today, man, as we follow our passions and someone that has turned their passions into profession, and all of us are here and all of us see the grind of several of us that have been on the same grind and the same journey for several years. 10 years, let's continue to keep going further. We appreciate everyone that is here. Let's salute. And Philip, continue to keep working, baby. I love you.
Appreciate you. Good work, baby. Congratulations, bro.
I'm gonna pass it to Sis, because she's been there this whole time.
Go on, Sis.
Yeah.
So first and foremost, I just want to say thank you for everybody that's here. When you take a look around, these are the people that my brother really admires and respects. And these are the moments that he cherishes. Even though he give all y'all hard time, and he might get a headache at times, just know that, you feel me, this is one of the most loving and caring people that you will ever run across, period. I don't care if you want to basically call him Filthy Rich or you want to call him Philip. He's going to be the same person regardless. I done watched this man when he made the decision of when he was going to come off the block and grind and turn his grind into a music grind. When nobody was respecting him, when nobody was listening to his music, when nobody wanted to promote him, when nobody wanted to be there, he still pushed through. He never hated on nobody. He always welcomed everybody. He always showed them how to make a grind, whether it was pressing up CDs, whether it was talking to people, going to certain shows, whether it was merchandise. He never hated on nobody. He never closed no doors, and that's why he continues to have the blessings that he has. And so at the end of the day, he is hard to deal with, but it's because nobody ever opened that door for him.
Let's keep rolling
and
thinking that he is hard to deal with.
I
got numerous.
I'm talking names, though. Y'all ain't finna keep saying I'm hard to deal with, though. That's fucked up.
Yes.
Look, cookie no too.
You just gotta
know. I don't know.
You know how to deal with him. You understand his rhyme and his reason. You understand his mad chaos. You understand why it means so much to him. Nobody ever opened a door for him. Everything that he's ever had, he opened it for himself. So therefore, trying to tell him how to do it doesn't make sense to him. So sometimes you have to sit back and let him do what he's gonna do because he's been this far by himself. You understand what I'm saying? So what I'm gonna tell you and everybody else is I love this man and I'm riding to the wheels motherfucking fall off. And if you ain't with it, hey, another year, the pictures get fewer and fewer. You get what I'm saying? So, respect him, love him. If you know who he is, listen to his voice. Pay attention to his posture. You get what I'm saying? Some things that he ain't gonna say. If you love him, you gonna know what he talking about before he even say a word. And that's all I'm saying is love my brother for who he is. Ride with him regardless. You feel me? It ain't about a Filthy Rich, but it's about a Philip Anthony Beasley, and we love you to death, brother. Much continued success,
and I appreciate everybody for being here. Thank you.
This is from a request from Chelsea about Philip Beasley. This is the street side of Philip Beasley. So, my name is Cook. My name Anthony too. So when I was me and Phil thought, he said, you know, my son named Anthony too. I'm like, yeah,
through the razor room.
I mean, my son named Anthony too. I was lost in the streets. I didn't know nothing about rap. My first video, this is a true story. The film that I was filming, I pulled up in Bentley. I tried to pull out some money and give it to Phil. Say, Phil, bro, you know, you doing a video with me? Well, Phil said, when I tried to pull that money, he said, man, I don't want no money from you. I didn't know who to shoot a video with. Swear to God. I didn't know how to make a video. Phil, at the video, took my phone and said, you too fly. Man, give me your phone. You need to start your Instagram. I swear to God, my first pictures on my Instagram, it's Phil taking a picture. No cap. It's Phil taking a picture saying, you gotta show this, Bentley. You gotta show this. You tripping, bro. Like, here's Damon Jamal. This how you shoot a video. This how you put it on World Star. This how you get in the rap. And the most important thing, this man told me, I felt like I'm a smart motherfucker. Nobody can't tell me nothing. He said, man, don't ever put your hustle over your career. Your career lasts forever. Your hustle is short term. And after I learned that, he didn't have to tell me no more. I said, I'm a rapper now because of what I was in, it's death or jail. You know what I'm saying? But this guy done taught me, you know, I'm on my fourth year. He on his 10th year. But before I even put a song out, he was coming to the studio and said, let me hear that shit. All right, well, you need to come like this or you need to do it like that. I never looked at that man like he was hating. Or, you know, it was, of course, it's competition because, like I said, this is a fly nigga. You was a hating ass nigga if you look at a fly nigga and say, man, I like that watch. I want one like that.
I like that car. I want to ride like that. That's why a man like this who's been doing it for so long is an inspiration for all of us.
Yeah.
Period.
You know what I'm saying? And if you don't say that, then you hate it.
Then you a hater.
Give him his props, y'all. You know what I'm saying? He done helped a lot of us. So just on my testimony, I'll be a fake nigga if I say Phil ain't a part of making cookie money. So I want all y'all to remember, when y'all see me, I don't think I'm trying to take a credit off of him. He's a part. I'm independent, yeah, I got my own money in the streets. I did all of that. But as far as this rap shit, I was at his house, remember Phil? Mm-hmm. In Vegas? Mm-hmm. My bitch fagged off. my heart was kind of broke. I was at Phil's house. I'm looking at, I see this nigga bougie. This nigga got 5'9", all. He got seminary all in his house. Y'all put that on my dead daddy. You go to my house right now, it's cookie money pictures from the same motherfucking, artist.
And the reason why I did that.
From the same artist that the pictures in his house, I was in his house with no house.
I got a picture of food stamps.
Bitch fagged off and everything on me. I was in his house and I was like, this nigga bougie, this nigga got fierce seminary. Right now, to this day, in my house, I got all pictures, cookie money, and my shit. Nigga, 9B Street. Nigga, so now my homies look at me like, you the bougie nigga. Nah, I went to this nigga like, this a street nigga. He came up from nothing. You gotta respect, I don't care about no music or nothing. Just respect the evolution of what. It take 10 years to be an overnight success. Now we take a toast, because he did it. 10 years for overnight success. To Phil.